Hi, my name is Javeria and I'm a first year engineering student at Monash University, Australia. So for me, questions like will I get into a reputable university and what major would be right for me were of utmost concern after high school. And I'm sure a lot of us feel lost making these decisions. However, StudyCo has been immensely patient and supportive throughout this journey. The support and guidance provided by Ms. Mubaraka and the effort she took to go above and beyond for my future gave me a sense of security and relief. Additionally, StudyCo has been accommodating and extremely understanding, and that is why I would strongly recommend StudyCo to anybody.
Hello, I'm Jason Matthias, and I went to Indian School Muscat and graduated in the year 2017. I then approached StudyCo, specifically Miss Annette Rosario, to gain help in pursuing my studies in the United Kingdom. It was a very smooth process from the beginning till the end. The list of required documents were given to me well in advance. The procedures were laid out very well and the visa procedures were explained thoroughly. With the help of Miss Annette and her persistent work towards my application, I was able to make my way into Solent University in Southampton, United Kingdom.
Hi everyone, my name is Rochelle Vaz and I'm a former ISMite. After passing out from ISM in 2014 with flying colors, I really wanted to pursue MBBS to become a doctor, but I just didn't know where to begin. I came across StudyCo just by chance, and they provided me with excellent guidance, not just in understanding the gravity of medical education, but also showed me the right path to achieving my dreams. They guided me all through the application process for Monash University Malaysia, which is an Australian university in Malaysia, and took away a large part of my anxiousness in this regard.
Hello everyone, my name is Rapali and I am currently studying in Australia. So I always had this dream of going and studying abroad, and StudyCo has helped me immensely in achieving my dream. So I am here in Australia just because of them. They helped me in every step of the way, from filling in applications to arranging documents, filling in visa applications, everything. Even though the process was so complicated, they made it very easy. They do everything for you and they never get irritated, even if you ask them small questions again and again. So I encourage you all to go through StudyCo. They are wonderful people and I would recommend them to everyone. Thank you.
So there are a few cool programs and services we offer at StudyCo that you may not know about. First group, for all the teachers, principals and education staff out there, StudyCo has a range of professional development programs in every aspect possible, leadership programs, education management, and courses to upskill. We can also organize overseas tours for counselors, teachers, and principals with Australian schools, universities, and the Department of Education. The delivery? Of course, we can deliver these programs in person in Australia as a tour, or we can even do virtual tours of exactly the same experience in the current situation. Another great aspect of these teacher training programs is that we can bring someone right here to Oman or any other part of the world to conduct this training. At StudyCo, we are flexible, we can tailor-make solutions to suit your needs. The second group. This one is for all students, parents, teachers, and anyone really. StudyCo offers online courses in every single field imaginable, including business, engineering, health, law, oil and gas, soft skills like CV writing, interviews, personal development, English, the CELTA, I still haven't even scratched the surface. So you name it, we can arrange it. These can be completed in a matter of hours, days, or months. You pick. Come to us with your subject of interest, or let us help you pick. Give us a time frame and we can deliver it online. If you have any questions, our office in Qurum is open for business and you can come meet any of our team in person to discuss your future study journey. Hope to see you there. I'm Mubaraka. I'm here in the StudyCo Oman office and I wanted to take this opportunity to answer some common FAQs from students and parents. Number one. So at StudyCo, we do the entire application and visa process for you free of charge. So that means we have counselors that help students decide exactly what they want to study, which university is best for that area of study, and the right destination country to suit all your needs. We then gather your documents and the rest is done by us. Number two. So StudyCo assists in finding the right accommodation options, and we generally recommend that the student stays on campus for the first year of their degree. Health cover, we have a great provider in Allianz, and the processes are done entirely through us. In terms of the on-the-ground support, StudyCo's headquarters are located in Australia, with countless onshore services available to students at all times. Students or parents can get in touch with any StudyCo staff across our offices in over 20 countries, and we will help you out. We can even take care of your travel needs. So we provide a truly comprehensive service. And don't forget, it's free. Question number three. So we know that permanent residency and migration is always on everyone's minds, especially when it comes to studying in Australia. At StudyCo, we have great migration agents that can personally help guide you through the entire process, including any questions you have. We are all about making things just that much easier for students, parents, and teachers. And the final question, why Australia? So at StudyCo, we send students to study across the entire world. There isn't a single country we haven't tapped into yet. So you can come to us with any destination you have in mind. We do specialize in Australia, and as you all know, Australian institutions are ranked amongst the top in the world, and so is our standard of living. These universities also offer great part scholarships, grants, and are ranked very highly for graduate employability. So I think that definitely solves a lot of the concerns that all the parents out there would have. If you have any other questions, our office in Corum is open for business, and you can come meet us and any of our StudyCo staff at any time. Hope to see you there.
Good evening. I am Vishwanath Praveen, Assistant Head Boy of Indian School Muscat. I extend my warmest congratulations to Honorable Union Education Minister, Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal, for receiving the prestigious Watain International Summit Award. It is my privilege and honor to welcome you, sir, to Avenir 2020.
Good evening, everyone. Dear audience, you are requested to fill in the feedback form, which will be posted in the description box. We are delighted to have you all with us today for Avenir 2020, a mission to enkindle the minds of students in diversified fields and motivate them to choose the course of their interest and caliber. I am Faizan Naji of Class 11E from Indian School Muscat, your host this evening, and it's my privilege and pleasure to welcome you all this beautiful evening. First and foremost, I take this opportunity to express our profound gratitude to His Majesty Sultan Haitham bin Tariq for his great vision, leadership, and benevolence. May the Almighty bless His Majesty and this beautiful nation with peace and prosperity. I deem it my privilege to extend a hearty welcome to Honorable Chairman, Board of Directors, Indian Schools in the Sultanate of Oman, Dr. Baby Sam Samuel, and Honorable Members on the Board, Mr. Ajay Kumar Jay, President, Indian School Muscat Management Committee, esteemed members of Indian School Muscat Management Committee, our Honorable Principal, Dr. Rajiv Kumar Chauhan, Presidents and esteemed members of all Indian School Management Committees in the Sultanate of Oman, Honorable Principals, Vice Principals, Assistant Vice Principals, Supervisors, Coordinators, Heads of Departments, Teachers, Parents, and Students. Today, we are privileged to have with us the representatives from SP Jain College, Dubai, who will discuss the courses available with them.
This is from SP Jain. Are we going live? This is from SP Jain. Are we going live?
Yes, Dr. Banerjee, you can go live now.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. So I'll be sharing my PowerPoint, right?
You can share your screen. You just speak to the host.
Thank you. Fantastic. So is my presentation visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. Just let me know whether I am absolutely clear. Is my audio clear and my video is also clear? Are you able to hear me with clarity, ma'am?
Yes, it's clear. The audio is clear.
And are you able to see my PowerPoint, the opening slide?
I think a little more clarity for the slides.
So
I think you can go ahead.
Go ahead. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Let me place my sincere gratitude for this absolute grand event. I can only see the number of participants just increasing by the second. Thank you. Thank you so much and a great evening. Amidst the very difficult situation, we are definitely blessed to have such a great audience, wonderful audience. And I place my sincere regards to everyone who has been behind the scenes in pulling this wonderful event, which I'm sure is going to benefit a lot of students and parents which look for various opportunities in today's world. So I represent SP Jain School of Global Management in the capacity of a deputy dean of the master's program and the global director of student admission undergrad. I've been associated with SP Jain for around 12 to 13 years. So it's an absolute privilege for me to present before you SP Jain's portfolio of products in undergraduate admissions. Before I move on, I would like to show something which might interest to all our parents and our students in terms of who do you want to be when you finally graduate? It's a tough question in terms of the difficult situation we are in, but let's understand what exactly you want to see yourself in another 3 to 4 years' time. And let me take you through a student's journey at SP Jain. So let me take you through one student who completed his grade 12 from Indian School Muscat in 2010. After having completed his schooling, he joined SP Jain's Tri-City BBA program in 2010, the same year. Having joined our global program of BBA, The student interned in the three global cities, Singapore, Dubai, and Australia. As part of the school's exchange program, the student studied a year in York University's Schulich School of Business and finally graduated from SPJ in 2014. As one of the top achievers and a very good student, the student was awarded with President's Award, which we call the Presidential Award for Global Citizenship, the highest award honor awarded by our school to recognize the overall excellence of a student. And the student also made to the Dean's List. The student was as you, one of you who have graduated from Indian schools. But what happened to the student after that? The student, while he was studying with us, was able to complete the Chartered Financial Analyst Level 1 in the same year. And as a part of recognition, he joined as an analyst in Kotak Mahindra Bank in 2014 and worked there for 2 years. His story moved on. In 2 years' time, he moved into one of the most reputed international investment banks among the top five in the world, Morgan Stanley, as an associate in investment banking in 2018. But he figured out there is something bigger for him awaiting. And in a year's time, he moved to Dubai and joined Bank of America Merrill Lynch in Dubai International Financial Center as a senior associate in investment banking in 2019. So in a matter of less than 5 years, the student moved on to one of the position which many master's student would covet to be in. The student is our own Anirudh Prem Kumar, an amazing student. If you look into his story, he was no different from what you are of today. But what he chose was something which many might fear of choosing, doing a program in three countries where majority of student of your age would not like to move from his or her comfort zone and would like to do a program in only one country. So the question is, what has Anirudh become? Anirudh has simply become confident. And that's exactly what SPGN does to you. It brings the confidence in you, and that confident version will be recognized by everyone in the industry of tomorrow. So the question is, what do you do in Singapore and why we choose our Tri-City program? Please understand, SPJN, an Australian business school of Indian origin, provides education in three global cities. So any student who studies with SPJN studies in Singapore, Dubai, Australia, and of course, there is another choice of Mumbai as an additional location to replace one of the program legs. Why Singapore? Singapore, being the fourth largest financial center in the world, happens to be Asia's top logistic hub. With strong connections with the West, it forms a strong confluence as West with East, and one of the most popular expatriate destinations in the world, apart from being one of the cleanliest, safest, and the best places to business. As a result, year on year, Singapore has been ranked as the world's most competitive economy, with home to four largest ethnic groups of Chinese, Malay, Indian, and the Eurasian. Singapore happens to be one of the favorite destinations of students. Why Dubai? Needless to say, we all know Dubai is one of the most leading destinations of the business, not only in the world, but also in the Middle East. World's most cosmopolitan city, again, one of the safest cities to be in. Residents come from over 200 countries and speak over 100 different languages. Similar to Singapore, one of the world's top 10 cities for expatriates, making it one of the top five livable cities in the world. It happens to be the world's leading global player in transportation and logistics, and soon going to be one of the most smartest cities in the world in terms of technology and innovation. And needless to say, for those who are in the Middle East, understand it is one of the safest cities in the world. And why Sydney? The final destination of our program, why Sydney? Apart from the fact Sydney offers a host of opportunity, which Ms. Mubaraka spoke about in terms of job opportunities, which we'll speak later on, Sydney happens to be one of the world's most green, global connected cities and ranked five most livable cities in the world. A balanced lifestyle, great outdoors, vibrant art and culture scenery, and headquartered to almost 40% of the top 500 Australian corporations, and Australia's leading center of innovation, entrepreneurship, home to around 35% of Australia's startup. Imagine student with coming from a country able to mix, match, live, study, learn, and mingle with the cultures of three completely divergent cultures, the mind becomes completely global. And that global mindset is what SP Jain tries to create in every student. So, what will you do in these three cities besides studying? That's very important. Why you need to travel? That's a question that most of us ask. Here's what our students typically do in their first year of their studies in Singapore.
Thank you.
So the list can go on. This is just in a matter of a year's time where students engage in significant number of out-of-classroom activities, which shapes their overall well-being and shapes their overall strong 360-degree view of the world. The question is, how will it help you? How does studying in so many places help a student? Well, we believe that when a student moves around the world and gets an exposure to various cultures, the student becomes globally intelligent. The student expands his horizon and gains a global mindset, the much needed mindset of tomorrow's world. Student will work in global teams and establishes a powerful network. And finally, he will be able to decipher what technology and how technology is disrupting the business globally. Finally, we believe and we have seen that students, when they move across campuses, they move across and understand the cultures, they develop global social skills, which in turn prepares them for the global job. So in a nutshell, when a student studies in different cultures, studies in different countries with different cultures, the student establishes a global mindset, which is very different from a student studying in one country, which doesn't make them socially as well-rounded as it can be when moving across the globe. Well, so what kind of real-world skills make them future ready? Let's see.
Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. John Lodewicks. I am the Vice President Academic of the S.P. Jain School of Global Management. I want to share with you about the classroom of the future. The classroom of the future that we have today at S.P. Jain. We call it the Engaged Learning Classroom, or ELC.
Good morning, Jaguars.
Good morning.
Okay, it's wonderful to see all of you. So let's continue where we left off in our last class. In our last class, we talked about data privacy, we talked about ethics in business. And I'd ask you to read an article about the Facebook Cambridge Analytica scandal, which just erupted this year in March. So let's go into the World Economic Forum, in its Future of the Jobs report, identified complex problem solving, critical thinking, and creativity as the top three skills of 2020. But here's where the problem lies. Traditional classrooms don't really do a good job when it comes to developing these skills. What we have done at S.P. Jain is something quite innovative and different. We've created this learning ecosystem called the Engaged Learning Classroom that focuses on helping students develop the skills they were actually used to work. Skills like problem solving, communication, teamwork, critical thinking, creativity, and business intelligence. So unlike a traditional classroom where you take notes and you watch a PowerPoint, in the ELC, you will discuss, you will debate, you will argue, and you will ideate. And faculty will engage you by asking questions. Questions like, what would you do if you were the CEO of a business that is not doing well? Or how would you expand your business across a new market? So as we've seen, Facebook has been in the news recently for quite a number of scandals, most importantly for breaching data privacy and election interfering. I would like you to imagine that you are the CEO of Facebook, you are Mark Zuckerberg, put yourself in his shoes. How are you going to assure your investors, your customers, and your shareholders that you have their best interest at heart? Please come up with one integrated solution to address three areas: government regulation, your own customer base, as well as the branding of Facebook. You've got 2 minutes. Time is up. Let's have a look at all the responses. Okay, I think we've got some great responses here. Let's do a quick poll on the top three. So Sarah, what have you voted for and why did you make that choice?
I voted to have data regulated, and to be honest, I don't think Facebook is solely responsible for the data breach.
It's nothing like what you would expect to do in an undergraduate program. You will be cold called, you will be challenged to really think and make smart decisions. You will participate in polls and quizzes. One thing is for sure, you won't find yourself in the middle of a boring lecture.
That's an interesting point. I think Keegan wants to ask a question.
Yeah, Sarah has a very interesting viewpoint, and I'm all for the regulation changes. But as the CEO, I would take accountability, outline fixtures, and focus on reassuring my customers that we are very serious about protecting their data. I really like the fact that there is a spirit of healthy competition in the class. We are constantly challenging each other to step out of our comfort zone and think out of the box. We are active, invested, and really on our toes.
I think both your points are excellent. Now, what I would like to do is I would like all of us to get together in groups and to figure out whether Facebook should be split up, because currently it is occupying a monopoly. If we're splitting up Facebook, then we can... The questions are drafted in such a way that you have to step out of the shoes of a student and into the shoes of a business leader. And using whatever information you have and drawing upon the concepts that you've learned from the classes, you have to frame your solutions. Over a period of time, you really start to understand what makes businesses tick, why leaders make the decisions they make, and how they can creatively solve a problem. Now, if you're responsible for the next phase of Facebook's growth, what would you do first? What would be your number one priority? Please submit your responses using your tablets. An exciting feature of the Engaged Learning Classroom are the tablets that you see students using. These tablets are equipped with features that allow you to virtually interact with faculty while the class is in progress. You can virtually raise your hand to ask a question. You can ask the faculty to slow down or go faster. You can participate in a quiz or a poll. You can take notes and you can share your documents in real time. You can bookmark a lecture and watch it later from the comfort of your home, cafe, or wherever you are. So how do we know that students actually develop the skills that are needed? Are you in the top 10% of the class in creative thinking? Do you need to improve your business intelligence? How are you faring in critical thinking? Scoreboard keeps track of your performance every single day and lets you know how well you are doing versus the rest of the class.
Hi, Prof. I was just looking at my scoreboard and I don't think I'm doing very good in creativity.
You seem to be doing really well in terms of critical thinking and business intelligence. In fact, you were in the top 10% of the class. I also thought you made a really good point today when you talked about business ethics. What I could do is I could send you some case studies. You could go through them and we could discuss them later this week. And I can also give you some additional practice material to work on.
I like to think of the ELC as a gymnasium, where you come in every day, exercise your brain, build your creative stamina, and train yourself to think like a business leader. And the scoreboard as a weighing scale that lets you know exactly how you're progressing.
You get to know the facts, how good you are at creativity, what you need to do to improve your critical thinking skills. You really get to figure out your strengths and weaknesses and take all the right steps to improve your game. I think that's pretty amazing.
Hi, we're from South Korea.
Hi, I'm Jaya from Dubai.
Hello, everybody. My name is Joel and I'm from Finland.
I'm from Mexico.
Hi, my name is Aida and I'm from Kyrgyzstan.
Hi, I'm Serena from Italy.
Hi, I'm Kyujin and I'm also from South Korea.
Hi, I'm Shriti. I'm an Indian, but I used to reside in Dubai.
Hi, I'm Monica from Poland.
And I'm from Mongolia. Also, you can call me Josie or Ninjin.
Hi, I'm Christine from Philippines.
Hi, I'm Una and I'm from South Korea.
Hi, I'm from the Dominican Republic.
Hi, I'm Aino, I'm from Finland.
Hi, I'm from Kazakhstan.
We are the class of 2019.
So as you can see, SPGN has always been at the forefront of technology, and our classroom of the future is one of the game changers in the world of education, especially undergraduate education, which requires significant engagement with the student, which is very different from the chalk and the talk method that we traditionally used to follow. Today's students, especially undergrad students, are much more engagement oriented, and they are much more knowledgeable in terms of information that they have. So it's all about how you can engage them more inside the classroom. And our engaged learning classroom, or ELC technology, has changed the way we have looked at undergrad education. As a result, you can see we have been able to attract students from all over the world. Needless to say, SPGN has a strong focus, places a very strong focus on faculty. And our faculties come, apart from our in-house faculties, our faculties come from some of the best of the business schools. Being a lean, young business school, we are able to attract significant number of faculties from some of the best in the world. They hail from all over the world. They are research-led. They are practice-oriented. So they are able to bring the academic and the practice gap as narrow as possible. And as a result, they are able to give the student evaluation and typically, which are very, very high. Now let's talk about what eventually it results into. We are able to move our students across three locations. Our students are being able to embrace global culture, create a global mindset. Our students are studying with students from across 30 different countries. So their peers are from all over the world. So what it eventually leads to? It leads to graduate success. Let me speak a little about the graduate success of the 2019 batch. As Ms. Mubaraka has initially mentioned, Australia happens to be one of the leading destinations of choice by students. And as a result, for SPGN, 50% of our students have secured jobs in Australia. Over 50% of our students have secured jobs in Australia, and the rest in different parts of the globe. We'll talk about it. And 50% has opted for post-study work right in Australia, which by means of studying 2 years in Australia, students can offer post-study work right to stay 2 more years in Australia, with an average graduate salary clocking Australian dollars, 55,000. Other top placement employment destinations for 2019 batch has been United States, Germany, Dubai, Japan, Singapore, Brazil, Argentina, Vietnam, India, and in Africa, Rwanda. The top recruiters have been some of the top companies across the world who recruits undergrad students and provides a great platform for growth and career. So what our students graduate with? Our students graduate with an Australian degree. As we said, technically we are an Australian business school accredited by TEXA and recognized by CRECOS. So once a student completes his graduation with SPGN, the student graduates with an Australian degree. Our global ranking speaks volumes about our standards in terms of both our academic standard as well as our compliance to regulatory standards. Since 2011, we have been consistently ranked among the top ranking agencies across the world, which includes Financial Times, Forbes, Economic Times, Times Higher Education, Nielsen, and many more. As the latest 2019 ranks us in our master's program in the top 15 of the world, as a result of which we have been able to gather significant association with the industry, which is helping us in our undergrad also. So what are our undergrad offerings? We are a business school, so we offer business programs. Our primary business programs are a BBA program, Bachelor of Business Administration. It's a 4-year tri-city program with students study in Dubai, Singapore, and Sydney. Year one, students study in Mumbai or Singapore, year two in Dubai, and year three and four in Sydney, with majors in marketing, finance, entrepreneurship, and an opportunity to pursue summer internship in each of the cities. And while in the program, do one exchange program with our 14 reputed international collaborative universities. Needless to say, the graduate with an Australian degree. We also have a bachelor's program, which is 3 years economics program. This is a Twin City program, studied in Mumbai and Sydney, year one in Mumbai, and the last 2 years in Sydney. It's a quantitative heavy subject with a special focus on some of the leading areas in economics, which provides top edge opportunities for students to pursue their careers in the area of economics, such as macroeconomics, monetary economics, international trade, and so forth. Again, students graduate with an Australian degree. We also have a 3 years Bachelor of Communication program, very similar to the Bachelor of Business Economics. The communication program is also a Twin City program where first year students study in Mumbai and the last 2 years in Sydney, especially for those who want to pursue their passion in areas of communication, intercultural communication, public relations, PR, visual communication, social media, etc. And we also have our latest program, which is the Bachelor of Data Science, one area which not only gaining popularity, but at the same time, there is a significant shortage of data scientists across the world. Very similar to the Bachelor of Communication and Economics, the Data Science program is also a Twin City program with first year in Mumbai or Sydney and the last 2 years in Sydney, which means students can study either in Mumbai or Sydney or pursue all 3 years in Sydney. It's an in-depth program with significant focused edge on data mining, artificial intelligence, machine learning, Internet of Things, etc. The opportunities lies in this area, the opportunities lies in data science labs and in global internships. Students graduate with an Australian degree after completing this program. Let's speak of some of our selected alumni from Oman, who is right now working in various companies in India and Singapore. As you can see, they're working and interning in State Bank in India. They're working in Growing Minds Achievement Center in India. In Singapore, they're working with the United Nations. Some of our students are also working in the Middle East, like Bank of America, Merrill Lynch, we spoke about Anirudh, and also students are working in Oman. We also have a student who are working in Australia. Some students who are working in Australia are in like Sharanya, Niharika, and Kenarik. So there's some of the students who come from various schools, which has been extremely, extremely benevolent to let us speak about our programs to their respective schools and has laid significant trust on us. A little about the post-study work visa. So students can opt for the post-study work visa after completing our program, since every program of ours, the last 2 years of the study is in Australia. So students can opt for the post-study work visa, which is the first stage towards working in Australia as a full-time employment opportunity. This becomes an attractive outcome for graduates with a bachelor's degree from SP Jain. On completing 2 years of full-time academic study, the students are eligible to live and work in Australia for 2 years. And as I said before, in 2019, over 50% of graduating class opted for the post-study work right. But of course, the post-study work right is subject to the immigration clearance, as we all know. Our admission process is open for the February 2021, as well as September 2021. The admission process is three-stage. One, submit your applications online with an aptitude test one has to go through. If somebody has taken a SAT score with a minimum criteria of 1250 plus, they need not go for this SPJNS test. Step two, appear for an interview with a senior faculty member at SPJN in areas which includes business creativity test, essay writing, case discussion, followed by a personal interview. And finally, the offer will be rolled to the student in terms of whether the student is offered admission, whether the student is waitlisted, or the student is rejected. So we have a three-stage process where the student needs to go through in order to be part of SPJN. Needless to say, SPJN does provide scholarship. Scholarship are primarily merit-based, and these scholarships are given to students who are deserving. And as we have students who come from all over the world, so the criteria of scholarships are kept, keeping in mind the international stringent criteria of scholarship. Our admissions for September 2021 is open, and someone who is opting for the September 2021 will not be losing a year in terms of the admission process, because the student will be doing the first year from the two terms of first year from January till August and will be joining the October 2020 batch in 2021. So anybody who has not taken admission in 2020 will be in October, will be able to join with the 2020 batch by taking admission in January, February 2021. But other than that, our normal batch commences in 2021, October. For any information, anyone can get in touch with us. And of course, StudyCo is there for us. We accept students. I mean, we work very closely with StudyCo. So there is needless to say about that collaboration. So, but anyone wants to know more about SPJN, can visit spjn.ae. For specific information, can email us at ug.dubai@spjn.org or call or WhatsApp at the given number, 555-387-080. Thank you so much for being patiently hearing. We are open for questions and thank you so much. I place very humbly my sincere thanks on behalf of Team SPJN to everyone, especially the team of StudyCo and all the members who have painstakingly made this event so successful. Thank you so much.
Wow, that was quite an impressive presentation. Now, let us move on to the queries from our audience. The first question, can you please elaborate about the various programs or courses offered by the university under science, commerce, and art streams?
Wonderful. So primarily a Bachelor of Business Administration program attracts students from all fields. A business program doesn't look into students primarily coming from commerce, though we believe that business is only meant for students who are from commerce, but that is not the case. If you look, your parents who are actually in various fields of business, whether they are either doing business for somebody else or is in their own business, needless to say, they haven't come from one stream, which is commerce. They may be engineers, they may be from liberal arts. So the program is designed in such a way that in the first year of our program, the courses are all common for everyone, which basically cements the very idea that a business is meant for anyone who comes from any field and then specializes onto a specific field. So needless to say, you come from any field, a BBA program is meant for you. But if you have a passion for something specific, then we have the 3 years program. If you want to be an economist, the program for economics is there for you. If you want to be in communication, you are coming primarily, you can be from arts and take that course in communication, but you can be from any field again. And if you are from science, obviously, you would like to be in data science program because that's the emerging trend of tomorrow, data scientists. But again, needless to say, you don't have to be a science graduate to take a data science program. You can be from any field. It's all about what really kicks you, what you really want to be in. So we are open. We do not restrict anyone to join any of our program. So it's absolutely open. Anyone can join any of our 4 programs depending upon his or her passion.
Thank you, sir. Does the university have a scholarship program for deserving students? How can one avail it? Please advise.
Absolutely. So a scholarship is something which is very much there for SPJN, and we will make it very clear. Scholarship is meant for scholars. So our scholarship is strictly, primarily, 90% of the weightage of a scholarship is given to your board results. To your board results. So students who score higher stands a chance to get a higher percentage of scholarship as compared to somebody who has scored lower. Now we do not have, we cannot tell you exactly what is the scholarship offer for a reason that we accept applications from all over the world and our scholarships are limited in terms of our offer. So therefore, when a student applies and secures his place, the student, as early as possible, the student will avail the scholarship much earlier. But yes, the scholarship the students can get can range from 10% of the tuition fee to complete 100% of the tuition fee. Yes, that is available, but only for a select few. The 100% will be only for a select few who eventually we believe are going to be the true brand ambassadors of the college. And this scholarship is for all 4 years of the program, subject to, of course, maintaining a minimum CGPA criteria. So if a student is able to maintain the CGPA or a GPA year on year, the student can maintain the scholarship for all 4 years. So the trick here is to apply to SPJN, apply for the scholarship at the earliest with the admissions team, secure a place in SPJN and avail the scholarship.
Thank you, sir. Do we need to write an entrance exam or will grade 12 board marks be considered?
No. Board marks is primarily a hygiene factor for us. Students have to write an entrance exam. So first, they write a SAT exam. If they have written a SAT exam and they have scored 1250, they need not take our entrance exam. If they do not wish to take the SAT exam or ACT, they can write SPJN's entrance exam, which is an online test. The student doesn't pay for this online test, it's completely free. And the student will be trained on how to write this exam. As I said before, it deals with the basics of English, maths, comprehension, critical thinking, general knowledge, so on and so forth. Once the student clears the aptitude test, the student moves to the second round. In the second round, the student gives an interview with a senior faculty or the dean or the deputy dean of the program. Based upon the student's school leaving marks, which is 10th and 12th marks, the student's performance in the entrance exam, the student performance in the interview, the scholarship is rolled as part of the offer. Now it is up to the student to take the offer or reject the offer.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to the next question from our audience. What financial aid programs does your college offer and what's the fee structure?
The college do not offer financial aid because the school's scholarship program is very strong in terms of its offering. So the school doesn't have any financial aid. And in terms of the fees, students can and parents can visit spjn.ae, where based on the campus location and based on the mode of study, the fees changes.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to the next question. Is there any course related to social science?
No, there is no course related to social science with SPJN.
Thank you, sir. Are campus placements available? If so, from what all companies or institutions?
So I need to go back to my slide to show you what are the campus placement. Just give me a second. Yeah, these are my top recruiters. These are some of the recruiters across the globe. I believe you're able to see that. And just to let you know, our jobs primarily, 50% of our jobs are in Australia, with an average salary of AUD 55,000. The rest are in all parts of the globe.
Thank you, sir. How does your career planning department compare to other colleges and universities?
I do not know about what other universities do in terms of how they prepare, but I think the proof of the pudding is in the eating. The student's success, I gave you an example of an ISM student who moved on to SPJN and today is working in one of the top three investment banks in the world, which is Bank of America, Merrill Lynch. That itself proves what our student is all about. And the list goes on. We have students who are working in Grant Thornton in Australia. So the list goes on. But it is not a matter which is done overnight. So from year one, student go through, if you carefully look at SPJN's courses, one of the course which SPJN does, which I have not come across done by any university, is called Global Employability Series course. This is done in each year. A Global Employability Series course primarily takes the student through the nuts and bolts of what it takes to be employable in the city in which they are. And this not only focuses on the hard skills of the subject, but the soft skills, which are very, very integral, very important and integral in creating a 360 degree view of the world. So SPJN places a lot of focus in the soft skills along with the hard skills, which is taught by some of the best faculties in the world. And it has resulted in significant graduate success.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to the next question from our audience. From where can we apply for the online entrance test?
SPGen.ae. So again, let me take you to our the slide, which is the last slide. I have to go back and forth. So give me a second. So this is where, sorry. Just give me a second. So this is where students apply. Students go to spgen.ae application, or students just simply write an email to ug.dubai@spgen.org, and our team would, within 24 hours, our students would get back to you. And, or even better, you can apply through StudyCo. I mean, we work very closely. Madam is there. I mean, she has been absolutely fantastic with us for years. So that's again an option for you. Or you can WhatsApp us at the given number, and we assure you that within 24 hours, you would get a positive response on the next step.
Thank you, sir. Also, when can we apply for this online entrance test?
Any point in time. You can apply any point in time. You can apply even today, because our intake is open for the February 21 as well as the September 21. You can prepare at any point in time. As I said, the faster one applies and the faster one secures the seat, until the time you accept the order, you don't pay anything. You don't pay for interview. You don't pay for application. You don't pay for applying. You don't pay for writing your admission test like SAT. You pay something. You don't have to. So therefore, you can get your, you can get as much as close to securing your seat as possible. And if you can do that as early as possible, your scholarship also gets taken care of as early as possible. So it's we are open to, we are receiving applications for 2021, both February and October. So you can do any point in time.
Thank you, sir. What are the campus facilities, and does the university have hostel facilities?
Yes, absolutely. In all our three, we have, so SPGen doesn't run like many universities do. We don't run branch campuses, please understand. So we are our own, so we are an isolated own campus. So we don't have branch campuses. We are itself owned, which means only a student moves from one campus to another. There is no branch which manages us. So each campus, we have hostel facilities. In Dubai, we have state-of-the-art facility, which we have 5 minutes from our campus. If you come to Dubai, we can take you, which is built by the government here inside the academic city. So in Dubai, our facility is in Academic City. Academic City is a city which houses a lot of universities. So our students stay just 5 minutes away, and we have transport facilities for our students to and from the campus, which students do not have to pay for, by the way. In Singapore, the facility, the accommodation is within the campus itself. So inside the campus, we have the facilities. And in Australia, similar to Dubai, the accommodation is hardly 5 to 10 minutes away. So students typically cycle to the campus or they walk to the campus. So in all these, we have completely furnished accommodation, which is at par with any student accommodation for any university across the world.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to the next question from our audience. Does the university provide students visa for Singapore, Sydney, and Dubai?
Absolutely. The visa is completely taken care of. So the Dubai visa and the Singapore visa is taken care of by SPGen. For Australia, no university can apply for Australia visa. So Australia visa, we give you the COE. COE stands for, something of enrollment. It's a letter, basically. It's a letter. So this letter is primarily the key to ensuring that you get your visa. So in terms of the visa, in each campus, we provide you with all the requirements of the visa so that you do not have to take the hassle of getting the visa in a very problematic way. So that is taken care of. I just recalled the COE is the certificate of enrollment. We provide you the certificate of enrollment, and that is a very important letter to secure your Australian visa.
Thank you, sir. Is the certificate issued from the SPG in Australia or under the name of the college in Dubai?
Yes, absolutely. So it's basically issued by SPGen, and this certificate becomes the certificate of enrollment for securing the Australian visa.
Thank you, sir. Has the university participated in competitions? If so, what all?
Everything what you can think of. Recently, we had the Middle East IMA challenge, which is the case study challenge, SPGN1, in United Nations, SPGN1. So, I mean, if you have seen my video, there are more than 50, in each campus, more than 50 different competitions which SPGN students participate. I think these are something which any university would be doing, I mean, any competition. So we are part of every competition that you can think of.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to the next question. What leads most students to choose this college?
Global. We are very unique. When we started our Tri-City program, we were the only Tri-City undergrad program. And I believe now a few has come up with option of sending their students in various campuses. What is striking is a student who studies with SPGN comes out much more confident with a complete different mindset as compared to somebody who has studied in one place. Unless one experiences it, one would never know that. So the striking feature of SPGN is a holistic focus on undergrad education, which goes beyond the classroom.
Thank you, sir. Moving on to a final question for this evening. What kinds of jobs do students go into after graduation from SPGN?
So the different kind of jobs, which are primarily in analyst position, you can speak about analyst position, in marketing position, in logistics position, and in digital marketing position. So students graduate with specializations in marketing, in finance, in entrepreneurship. So anything which students, anything which is a preparation, or I would say a entry-level job for an undergrad student, which gradually takes them to a specialized form of employment, is very much welcome for us.
Thank you, sir, for the informative presentation. Dear audience, I'd like to add
that I posted a link on the chat function, and like and follow the StudyCo Oman Instagram page and receive an application fee waiver. And StudyCo Oman will be running competitions for freebies in the next few weeks on the Instagram page. So do stay tuned. And for any further queries, please get in touch with the StudyCo Oman team. I've given the contact details in the chat function. And thank you, Dr. Banerjee. Thank you, Avaner, and the host. And stay safe.
Madam, is it Elizabeth, ma'am, speaking?
That's right.
Madam, Dr. is it Banerjee. Elizabeth, ma'am, speaking?
Yes, Dr. Banerjee.
Madam, we have a couple of... Madam, so nice to hear you. I mean, it's been always a pleasure to see you and talk to you. From the very beginning, we have been associated, especially me.
We have a couple of
our students who are in SPGN who are from actually Indian school, and since we have a few minutes, we would like them to have a little word. Like, we have a couple of students. One is from Indian School Darsiyat and one is from Indian School Muscat, who are right now currently studying with us. So if you allow, I mean, they can speak a little about their experience, which is from the horse's mouth.
I will just check Mr. Adil. Adil, is it possible? Do you have time for the students to speak a few words? Adil, the host, co-host.
Hi, ma'am. I'm ready to speak. Shall I start?
No, not that. Who's the co-host and the host? Yeah.
Hello?
You can start.
You can start. Go ahead.
Shall I start speaking?
Yes.
Yes, Adil, you can speak. Satvika, if you are there, you can speak. Satvika, if you can hear me. Okay, Adil is there.
Hi, everyone. My name is Adil Sharafuddin. I'm a graduate of Indian School Darsit, Batch 2020. Currently, I'm pursuing Bachelor of Business Administration at SPGM School of Global Management. I'm studying on 100% scholarship. Last 2 years, I was a participant of Avenir just like you all. But today, I'm here to share with you my experience at SPJ. So my story starts after this class 12 results. During that really stressful time of choosing college, it was my principal of Indian School Darsit, Mr. Alexander G. Verghese, who suggested me about SPJ and the scholarship. And hence, I'm very much grateful to my principal and teachers of Indian School Darsit for all their valuable guidance and support in my life. The first and foremost reason for joining SPJ is, of course, the Tri-City model. The program is conducted in 3 cities, which, as you all know, Dubai, Singapore, and Sydney. As a business aspirant, SPJ's Tri-City model is really beneficial for me to live and learn business in these cities where I am challenged to become stronger and independent every day. I will also get an opportunity to join internship and have relevant work experience in these 3 cities, which I believe will have a profound impact on my employability and career. Also, students graduating from SPJ have a golden opportunity to get PR for 2 years. To tell you about my journey so far, at SPJ, our classes are taught by professors from various nationalities. They are highly qualified and most of them having corporate backgrounds. Hence, every lesson taught in class have a lot of real-world experience. They are very friendly and always approachable for any help we require. Second, in this 1 month, we had guest lectures and talks from various business personalities to even the Minister of Israel. These lectures are a very valuable source of knowledge by giving exposure to the real world. And it is not only about the studies within the 4 walls of the classroom, but we were taken on 3 excursions in and around Dubai so far. We are graded not only based on the marks we get in exam, but on how we perform in class and in the group activities, thereby placing a great importance on various personal skills that cannot be written down in a paper. By combining best practices and knowledge of teaching and inculcating business practices and training, BBA at SPJ is a right course for me. Thank you, everyone.
So, a gentle reminder, we are running short of time. We need to end the session.
Wonderful. Absolutely. If you allow us just a minute more, we have a student from Indian School Muscat. Satvika, if you allow us a minute, we will not take more than that. Satvika, if you're there, if you can just introduce yourself and finish it.
Good evening, one and all. I'm Satvika Tipraneni, and I've recently graduated from Indian School Muscat. I'm currently pursuing BBA at SP Jain School of Global Management. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity for sharing my initial experience with SP Jain. Actually, I've come to know about SPJN when I was searching online for good universities. Its course design, Tri-City model, and Australian degree made me apply initially. In the due of admission, my interaction with admission coordinator, who encouraged me by saying, "We don't expect much from you. You are coming here to learn. Be very specific, clear, and in fact, be you." As well as my interaction with the interviewer who said, "I will make accounts interesting and easy for you when you come here." When I said I was not good in accounts, these few interactions made me decide that this is the right place. Nowadays, when most colleges expect every individual to be outstanding, SPJN practically helps an individual mentally and physically and helps to shape them. This university undoubtedly offers the best scholarships. It even offers a full scholarship if it thinks you have the potential. Being in this institute enables me to interact with people from different cultures, and the Tri-City model too helps to adapt easily to all types of situations, which is the most important in my field, which is Bachelor of Business Administration. SPJN is helping me to get out of my comfort zone by conducting various group activities and games. It's been exactly 1 month since college started, and I have made so many memories with my classmates because of activities and various interactions organized by SP Jain. Undoubtedly, choosing SP Jain was, and I strongly believe, is going to be one of the best decisions made in my life. Thank you.
Thank you, sirs and ma'ams.
Thank you so much. We are done from our side. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. We are done from our side.
As we come to the end of a wonderful session, I would like to express our gratitude to each and everyone behind the grand success of this session. First and foremost, I express our profound gratitude to His Majesty Sultan Haitham bin Tariq for his great vision, leadership, and benevolence. May the Almighty bless His Majesty and this beautiful nation with peace and prosperity. On behalf of Indian School Muscat, the organizing team, and the entire audience, I extend a very hearty vote of thanks to our speakers. We sincerely appreciate the time and efforts you took to share with us the courses you offer. Wholeheartedly, I thank Honorable Chairman, Board of Directors, Indian Schools in the Sultanate of Oman, Dr. Baby Sam Samuel, and honorable members on the board. Mr. Ajay Kumar Pillai, President, Indian School Muscat Management Committee, esteemed members of Indian School Muscat Management Committee, our Honorable Principal, Dr. Rajiv Kumar Chauhan, Presidents and esteemed members of all Indian School Management Committees in the Sultanate of Oman, Honorable Principals, Vice Principals, Assistant Vice Principals, Supervisors, Coordinators, Heads of Departments, and teachers for their support and guidance for organizing such an event. Thank you all for assisting and encouraging all of us. I thank all the students and parents for being with us today and for your active participation during the entire program. Signing off, this is Faizan Najib of Class 11A from Indian School Muscat. Thank you once again. Wishing you all success in your future endeavors. Stay safe.